Hi, this is Azul Maksud. Today I'm so much excited with very important another project, which has the two-tier application deployment with Kubernetes, auto-scaling, load balancing, and kOps. This project is very much important, specifically the guys who wants to do the career in the AWS DevOps engineering. So here in this single project, you can learn how to deploy the application in the Kubernetes, then how to auto scale, and then how to load balance using the kOps, Kubernetes Operation Manager. So here the action items in Kubernetes, auto scaling, load balancing, kOps, and Ingress. First of all, I'll create three EC2 servers, one master, and two workers for the Kubernetes in the VPC. Then I'll enable auto-assign public IPv4 for the public subnets. Then install the Kubernetes on the Kubernetes master. Then install the Kubernetes in the worker 1 and worker 2. Then join worker 1 and worker 2 into the Kubernetes cluster. Then deploy two-tier application in the Kubernetes cluster. Actually, I'm using the two-tier here, but you can use three-tier also. But just I'm showing up front-end and back-end, then you can get the real project idea. Then scale up the application deployment, also scale out, scale down, same thing. Create a Kubernetes cluster and load balancer using kOps. And let's go to the, and if you did not see earlier, before this project, I will suggest to go through my YouTube. Here everything is free. From here, I will suggest three-tier deployment with VPC, and then load balancing auto-scaling. Then how to deploy front-end app with S3. Then how to deploy front-end app with S3. Actually, this is S3 front-end app deployment. And it's a Docker Part-1, Part-2, and Swarm. You know this, if you go through this way, Docker Swarm, you will be also master in the Docker. And you must also see at least this Part-2, because the Docker Hub I am using here. Then the Kubernetes, the intro, how to install. So I'll suggest please go through from here, then you will be a perfect AWS DevOps engineer. And today's project is very much important. Let's go, let's start first. I'm creating EC2 for 3. I'm not giving the name right now. After creating, I'll give the name. 3 EC2s. And here you have to spend some money because Kubernetes does not run on free tier EC2. Because Kubernetes needs 2 CPU. Here is only 1 in the free tier. So T2 medium is good because T2 medium has 2 CPU, also 4 GB memory. And I'm using my old one, the key pair. If you don't have, just create here. And in the networking, auto assign public IP, I have chosen. It's enabled already. So I don't need it specifically. And of course, I'm using here security group, the default one. And this is all ports are enabled. Here should be 20 GB because lots of dependencies I'll, it should be very important because 20 GB is taking lots of dependencies. It's in the pending state. First of all, kmaster, Kubernetes master. Then kworker. I'm giving you kworker 1. Then kworker 2. This is standard in the industry, one master and two workers. They are running. Still status check going on. First of all, master. There's a public IPv4 because I assigned there. The mobile storm, let's go here. SSH. Then the public IPv4, then Ubuntu. Then private key. I use this one. Sit here. Guys, just come. And rest two also have to kworker one. Public IPv4. Session SSH. Username Ubuntu private key. Yes, so this is master, this is worker one. Let's go to the worker two. So same thing doing. You have to do lots of thing today here. Get prepared in mentally. IT needs patience. Lots of patience you have to have. So this is the master. I'm changing the just the name here. Right click, rename tab. Key master. This is kworker one. This is kworker two. Now I'll do multi exec. So see, this is the master, this is the worker one, worker two. Now lots of thing I have to do at a time. First of all, I have to update. And it should be upgraded. Why this is like that? Okay, it's good now. Control C, Control L. Yeah, it's good. Not the best. Then I will add Kubernetes repository for Ubuntu 22.04. Kubernetes needs lots of dependencies. Here the installer actually. Please go through here, computingforgeeks.com, then install Kubernetes cluster on Ubuntu 22.04 using Kubernetes. So I am now executing these commands. All the commands. Nothing hidden, and these guys are updated always. Every year, every month, even every week, they are updating something. So please go through first here. It will be easy for you. Write down. Now, I am also using call command here. Then from that page I already collected, copying multi paste. Clearing. Now I'm installing kubelet, kubedm and kubectl. So first of all, all the commands multi-paste. It's taking some time. See here, kubelet, kubedm, kubectl is installed and set on hold. That means now this is static. Master, worker 2, and worker 1, same. Okay, let's see the version jump. Yes. So version is 1.30.1. kubedm version this is. Guys, good morning. Now I need to specify the swap because lots of space I have to use here. So internally, sudo stream editor minus I, then swap, then this etc fstab. I have to see first here. Then I have to do swap off. Multi-paste I'm doing. Sudo swap off hyphen a is done, but inside etc fstab I have to do vim editing. Now see vim etc fstab insert I last line and enter, just one line I have to add, swap image none. You see here this last line, swap image none, swap sw00, ask shift colon wq. Now I have to do sudo mount hyphen a. Good. Now recheck free h. Yes, see, make sure swap should be 0 byte. So I have now lots of spaces to execute the application. I have to enable kernel module in the kernel mod probe overlay and br net filters. These two guys, overlay and br net filter. So this is module probe done. Now I'm configuring sysctl. All the commands I showed you here, all the commands. So don't miss the commands there. I already copied and making easy the life. I have to reload sysctl. Reloads here. Now I'm adding the repo and install packages. Multi-paste. It takes some time. Enter. Now I have to create directories, docker service.d, docker.service.d. After finishing this one, because in that directory the docker repo which I'm using here will be stored there. Next time making clear multi-paste. See sudo mkdir make directory minus p port etc systemd system docker.service.t. So it's so inside. You have to go first etc, then systemd daemon, then system, then created this one. It's very important to memorize. Memorize means just in the brain, that's it. Nothing to be memorized like that. So one more command for overlay. Overlay via net filter. These two guys very important. Should be cared. Now I am exacting. First systemctl daemon reload, then restart docker. You know, after restart always enable. So restart docker, enable docker, easy. Life is easy. It looks complicated, but if you know easily, easy way, then everything is good. Now one more command for loading modules. Systemctl done. Now I am going to interactive mode. Sudo minus I or root. See here. I am now in the root. Earlier was Ubuntu user, now in the root. Because root permission, I need lots of things. Now ensure the overlay and via net filters. Please remember, you have to ensure these guys every time after changing. Because overlay and via net filters, these two networks should be always good. Now I'm setting up required systemctl params. Again, I have to do the some params here and go to the systemctl. Now I'm adding cryo repo. If you missed my earlier video, please see what is cryo. I said there, cryo is the light, and in the industry now, this is very much popular, cryo, C-R-I-O. Now I'm installing cryo. It has many steps. Everything is there. Cryo overlay net filters. Yeah, it's done here. I have more commands for curl. Add cryo repo. Copy it, edit. When you see this blue color, then you are good. Everything is good here. Then I have to install cryo. Sudo apt update, then install cryo. Installing. And then I have to start, restart, then enable. Fail to restart. Okay. No worries. I have to update first. Showing the error there. Yes, now it's running. Active and running cryo. Active and running. Containers runtime interface for OCI. CRI cryo container runtime interface for OCI. This O means, this last O means OCI. This is a light container, so this is used now in the industry. Control C to stop. Now, worker is done, so only the masters have to work. Remember, kubectl should be installed only in the master or used. You can use install also worker, but not in the use. First of all, I have seen via net filter. I have to ensure ls mode grab via net filter. Yeah, via net filter 32,000 is good here. Then also breeze. So my network is good here. And I have to enable kubelet. So kubelet specifically to connect with worker. Enable this one. Then I am pulling container images with multiple CRI sockets. See here, CRS socket. It may take some time. So do kubectl config image is pulling up. Because after this image, I can create the cluster. Yes, for the cluster, I'm using this command, cluster. Every commands are here, guys. I'm showing you repeatedly. Nothing hidden. Everything is exposed to you all. See here, kubectl join, last two lines. Token, I have to copy last two lines. Then just sharing with worker one and worker two. Just keeping here. And to start using your cluster, cluster is created successfully with control plane. Control plane only should be in the Kubernetes, is created successfully. To start using your cluster, you need to run the following. As a regular user, if the regular user, then you have to make directory like this, then you have to change the ownership, then you have to run. But I am not the regular user. Alternatively, if you are the root user, see, I am here the root user, right? Here root user, so you have to run this and export. You have to export kubeconfig. It's easy, just right click, export it. Now I have to join the cluster, but let's see the cluster info. Sometimes kubectl cluster info not found. Yeah, it's good now. See, Kubernetes control plane is running at 172.31.48.179.6443. Code DNS is running at this location. HTTPS. Yeah, it's good now. So now I have to connect worker 1 and worker 2. Already I have taken the kubectl join token. Now just I am showing the location, CRI socket, then bash run cryo.stock. This one same also with worker 2. See, this is done. Starting kubelet, yeah. Kubelet, with kubelet, master and worker is connected. So run kubectl get nodes, then we can see the clusters, but it should be here. Do some bigger. See, this is the control plane, means master 179. This is the 179 is the master, and these two is the workers, 26 and 133. 26, 133. So I'm good now. This is added. Yeah, so initially this is done. Nodes is good here. Now I have to install network plugins. Kubectl apply, then the GitHub location I'm giving here. Now we works. If you missed, if you don't find out about this one, please see my other video. There is everything clear. Yes, it's done networking. Now I have to do beam bash beam tilde then slash forward slash dot bash rc bash record. Insert mode, I have to change the alias because every time kubectl is not good to write. See, some more is alias, just add here one more alias, then k equal kubectl, then about it, come down, yeah, ask colon WQ. Okay, now I have to do source. In the place of beam, I have to write source. Source, yeah, it's good. Now k get nodes. My bad. Nodes, see? No need to write kubectl. Only k alias is good. Earlier was kubectl. Alias is very nice. It makes life easier. Now I have to create dev namespace. First of all, I am creating mkdh dev folder. Now I have to go there cd dev. Now I have to create namespace. I'm making life easier. Just copy then paste. Now I'm saying kcreate namespace ns dev, then dry run client output yaml. So it should be in the namespace dot yaml file ls. See, here is the namespace dot yaml file. Now let's beam namespace.yaml insert. I don't need this guy. Kindness namespace good. Name dev. I'm good. No need spec. No need status. Just version name. Kind namespace. Metadata name. That's it. WQ. Now after creating, I have to apply. A apply hyphen f namespace. So namespace dot slash dev created. Good. Now k get namespace ns. See, I have created dev and this default and node list public and system, these are created automatically earlier by the system, but manually created this step. Now I have to insert, I have to create actually beam backend.yaml. First is backend, then frontend. This is also interview question. Backend.yaml I'm creating insert mode. And I'm inserting my backend. Here's the repo. This is my GitHub. You can go there and the repo, the paste repo. In the paste repo, this is for backend. Kubernetes backend part, frontend part. So making life easier. From here, just copy. Here is API version, kind, pod, metadata. Everything is there in the YAML format. And just right click. See here, version, kind, pod, and kind service. First of all, pod, then service. Service doing load balancing. And service providing the port also, connection. So here is the pod has the containers. The containers, I'm using image here. I need to go to tier backend image version latest. If you don't find this one, this is here, Docker Hub. I'm using this backend first, then I'm using this frontend first. You should have one account like this. And how I did post here, you can see in my Docker, maybe this one or this one, I forgot, I pushed. So for this reason, I am emphasizing, please go through from here, there, first this one, then 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 Kubernetes here. Then your brain will be perfect to catch today's this project. Okay, ask colon WQ. Now same way I am doing beam frontend.yaml. Same way, insert, and I'm going to my where is yes paste repo. I'm going to frontend. Yes, so from here, see, copy raw file, right click, see here, two kind, one is part, then service for frontend. So, frontend, this part has the image. Image, this is /2-tier frontend image, I'm using version 2. This image is here, Docker Hub, frontend image. This image has inside this version 2. And earlier, backend has only one version, latest. So I have used these two guys here. Okay. And in the service, kind service, my name is Mrs. Deb. Then spec, node port. And here target port 80 is the Nginx target port, and node port, Kubernetes giving this node port. I have specified 30,005. This one should be 30,000 to 32,207.67. Maybe I forgot exactly. Then selectors, F frontend, everything is good. WQ. So backend first, then frontend. Is done. Now I have to see kget pod, kubectl get pod -n, then kube -system. So how many pods in the kube system namespace? Lots of parts are in the kube system, but I have to delete CoreDNS and WebNet. So kdelete port CoreDNS. I'm CoreDNS is to right click space enter. Oh my bad. So I have to mention namespace which one? This is the namespace. This is the kube system. Yes, now delete it. Without namespace, it's not specified. Delete it. Same way, I have to delete webnets also. Make it easier. Webnets one. Space webnet 2 space webnet 3. Yeah, it's deleted. First, after deletion, I will apply backend first, then frontend. It takes a bit time, just wait this. This is midnight here. In the Ohio, this after working whole day, I need to go to sleep before sleep. I'm doing this one now. K apply -f backend.yaml. Yeah, good. Pod add backend created service backend service created. So pod and service. We need for backend and frontend, always remember this. Same way, here, backend YAML, frontend YAML earlier was, now namespace YAML also it is, earlier was. Now, same way, I have to do frontend. Frontend.yaml. Yes, frontend, pod, and service. Both are created. Good. Now let's see pod, kget pod, dev. So here backend and frontend both are ready and also running. Let's see the service. Kget sbc n means namespace dev. So here backend service and frontend service. Backend service on cluster IP, frontend service on node port. And 80 nginx 30005 node port. Let's take the Kubernetes master first. IP is changed because I reloaded this one to be 30005. Yeah, just come here. Reverse number is working. Summation should be working also here. 26, this one. So it's working fine. Yeah. With masters, let's see the workers. Worker 1 IP. Then 30005. Yes, it has come. It's working or not? Let's see. Good. Nice, good. Worker 2. So 30005. Should be random numbers. Reverse, yeah, done. So in total, submit. Summation is working. It's good. Now I'm scaling up and automate the flow of the cluster using replica set. So I'm changing the namespace context. Namespace context I have changed here. Looks some bigger, looking good. Let's see, kget pod. See, earlier I had to give kget pod hyphen n dev, then it's coming. After the context, set context, namespace dev, now no need to put the dev, just kget pod. Earlier was namespace dev. So this is the thing of set context. It's also interview question. How to avoid every time writing namespace? Answer will be set context. Set context, then current, then namespace equal dev. I have to answer this question one interview. I just said set context. Interview was very happy. Now I have to create a backend deployment. Now the deployment has come. Deployment created. Create deployment backend image. My unusual2go/2tier backend image, replicas 2, namespace dev, dry run client, output YAML, port 5000. All should be stored in backend RS replica set dot YAML. Let's see. Replica set, yes, this is created. Let's see what's inside there. Replica set. Wow. Whatever I have written here, everything has come here. See, image, a little to go, image, a little to go, has come. Same way, it should be two replicas, replicas to spec. See, it's really awesome. So guys, Kubernetes really, really very good. If you learn one time, you can't forget, and your payment will be very high. Unimaginable, okay. So now I have to apply this replica set. K apply hyphen F. Remember, always after apply is coming hyphen F. is very important because I'm used to forgot this one. Yes, so after applying backend rs replicaset, that means actually this is the deployment.yaml.apps. However, this name I have given, system is taking deployment. See, this is the deployment, but I just given this name like replicaset. Replicaset is the concept of deployment also. So just I have given like that. Now, let's see the kget pod. These two pods are replica. Backends replica, these two replicas. So just I'm deleting my earlier one. Kget pod, the old pod I'm deleting. Oh, it should be get delete, not get. Already seen kget. So backend is deleted. Still not. Then application should run on replicas. Just wait a bit, please. It's still working. Still working. Deleting them. This one will be no more. Let's see kget pod. See, no more backend here. Here is the backend replicas. Let's see our system is working or not. Is the worker node 2? Well, it's working. It's good. It should be also. Good. That means backend replica is working. Now, let's see the replicas. How many replicas are there? Then I'll create the front end replicas. Kget RS. RS is replica set. Only one replica here. Backend has created. Only one replica. Desired 2, current 2. So it's good. Backend replica showing like this replica set. This is under this replica set. Here is two ports, this one and this one. Very easy Kubernetes. If you learn one time, just easy. You can't forget, honestly. Learning process is some harder, but when Kubernetes in your fingers, you can't forget, honestly. See here. Create deployment. I'm creating deployment for front end image. I need to go two tier front end image version 2. This image in my Docker Hub. Remember, so you have to learn Docker Hub first. I'm saying again, please go here. This is the Docker part 1, part 2, part 3. So on there. So, Docker part 1, part 2, how to create the Docker file, then how to pull, everything is there. And if you like to learn AWS DevOps, then I'll start from here. Start from here, then this one, 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 then this one. So it will be easy for you. Okay, guys. So after creating, it will create also replicas, two replicas, namespace dev, dry run client, output YAML. It will be stored in the front end replicas. Yeah, this name I have given. So let's see. LS, yes, front end RSYAML has been created. Let's see, get front end hyphen RSYAML. See here, image, Azizul to go, my Docker Hub, I have written there. Then replicas, how many replicas? Two replicas here. So yeah, let's find everything as well. So now I have, after creating, I have to apply k apply minus f function, then front end hyphen rs YAML is, see, whatever name I have given is created with Jan deployment. Remember, it's also interview question, how to create deployment file, then how to create, then answer will be this one. Create deployment, then front end or back end, either way, then image, then port. Please memorize this thing. Create deployment, then front end or back end, then image. No need to memorize as usual to go. Just image, then port, then replicas, how many replicas, namespace, dry run, output, then which file, YAML file, any name. So you have to remember these guys for your interviews. It's not too much hard. If you practice many times, it will be very easy for you. So this is deployment for front end is created. Now let's see the kget pod. Here, backend replicas, two backend replicas. This front end is old one, front end replicas. So I have to delete the front end old one. This one I have to delete. This one. kubectl delete pod, which one? Front end. Right? Let's delete it. Kget pod. See, here is no backend or front end, the old one, all the replicas. This is replicas backend, this is replicas front end. So both are ready. One by one means expected and ready. Running. Yeah, it's good. No restart. Without restarting, it's working. Let's see our system is working or not. Now this is worker node 1. If worker not working, then of course master is working, right? Because it's coming from master. Ah, nice. Good. So it's working good. Now kget replicas to see. Replica is just RS. So replica set. Backend replica set has two ports. Front-end replica set has two ports. See? Interesting. This is replica set. So, replica set is created after deployment. Now I have to expose the backend deployment. Guys, let's see how to expose. Kubectl expose deploy backend, like kcreate deploy deploy, right? After kcreate, then expose. This is also interview question. When coming expose, before or after creating? After creating deployment, then coming expose. K expose deploy backend or front end, either way, then port, namespace, dry run, output, then the name. So I'm putting this on backend deployment. I'm doing this name like that. Okay. Ls, see here, backend deployment is created. So get backend deployment. See, whatever I have given here in this line, everything is here. 5000 target port is taking very nicely. When you write the deploy, it automatically is taking from the system. Then I have to expose the front end. Same way front end. Just the change is here. Earlier was back end, here is front end. That's the change. So let's see. Front end deployment created. Get. Here I'm doing get. It's not too bigger. Small. So it's making the service. Remember, when exposing the deployment, it's actually kind of service. Service exposing. So this is the service target port. Everything is coming here like that. Also, this standard is load balancers. The Kubernetes load balancers is controlled by which one? This is an interview question. Very, very important. You must have the answers right perfectly. Kubernetes load balancers. Every application deployment has the load balancers. So Kubernetes load balancers is controlled by which one? Kind. Which kind service? Kind should be service. Here we have which we was kind port, then kind deployment, kind service. That is kind service. So kind service has the load balancers. So this is very, very important. I had lots of times to remember this one. Okay. Now I just changing the port. It was earlier 30,005, the node port. Can you remember? So now I'm changing. Maybe the manager asking for 30,006 should be front end deployment. Yes. Manager given you the message. The client asked for new port, like 30,006. You have to change. First of all, node port is always in the service. Remember, kind service. Under the service, service is the load balance also. Under the service, here is the target port. Under the target port, you have to write your client's node port. Node port. Maybe 30,006, right? They're asking for. Okay, no worries. It's nothing for you. You know now everything. It's good. Now, kget sbc hyphen n dev. Here, see, still node port is 30,005 because I did not apply still, right? So I have to apply first. Always you have to apply first backend first, then front end. So I am applying first backend deployment, then the front end. Then you will see the magic. Yeah, front end created. Now see the service. See, here is front end. This one has 30,006, right? This one has 30,005. So the application is working on both now. 30,005 and 6. This is 5. Just making a copy. Or here, just writing another one. Just 6. See? Also 6. Also. Yeah, working. See? Good. Good. This is 6. 30,006. This is 30,005. This is also working. Yeah, it's good. Now I can delete kdelete sbc service, which one? Just 30,005. I don't need this. Okay, I'm deleting this one. The service is deleted. See, now there is no 30,005, only 30,006. Let's see, this is 5, right? See, it's working or not. I think sometimes should not be working after sometimes. we have to give some time.
Now,
yes, this is the end of the first part. So in the second part, I'll install kOps, then run Kubernetes cluster with kOps in the AWS. Then I'll scale up the application deployment in the AWS. I'll create Kubernetes cluster load balancer using kOps in the AWS. So let's see in the second portion also. Then you'll see the AWS auto scaling working there. AWS application load balancer is working. How it's working using S3 bucket. Amazing thing coming. So within with these two parts, it will become completed. Two-tier application deployment with Kubernetes, auto-scaling, load balancing, and kOps. Just put this line in your resume, and watch these two videos. This is the part one. The second part is coming tomorrow. So let's see. Hope you guys enjoyed. If you really like, please consider to subscribe and also like, comment, either way. Thank you. Have a great day.